Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Bob Devaney Sports Center. We're about set to tip it off for the C2 state championship between the Jets of Sterling and the Mustangs of Republican Valley. A couple of teams who have gotten here in rather different fashions. Republican Valley's had to really scratch and claw their way in. They beat Spencer Napier 59-54 and then held on to beat number one Sargent yesterday 63-61. While the Sterling Jets have breezed in here with a 79-41 win over Cedar Bluffs, and they really put Shelton away yesterday 74-60. At the end of the season, the Sterling Jets ranked number two. They were ranked number one much of the year. They have the only win over Adams this year. In fact, two teams that they've lost to will be playing for state championship titles here today, Adams and Lincoln Christian. This is a 16th time at state for Sterling. They were here last year. They were champs in D in 69 and D1 in 87. They averaged 74 points a game, give up 53. For the Mustangs of Republican Valley, they're 19-5, fourth ranked. As we say, they beat Spencer, Napier, and Sargent to get here. Third time at state, last time here, 83, no championships. They average 66 a game and give up 57. The Mustangs, coached by Dan Hilton in his fifth year at Republican Valley, they came in as the number five seed. And what's so deceiving about the seeding in this tournament is that it's based on record only, not who you played. Sterling came in as the third seed. They're coached by Brad Buller in his fourth year at Sterling. They, as we say, were ranked number two in the state at the end of the season. So if you take the polls, it's number two against number four. Let's give you the non-starters for Republican Valley. Dan Wolf is a 5'8 junior. Joel Rodenthal is a 6'1 sophomore. Jason Long is a 6'1 sophomore. Kurt Kiker, a 6'1 sophomore. Their super sub off the bench is Andy Haig, a 6'2 sophomore. He came off the bench to lead them yesterday with 17 points. Spencer Neely is a 6-foot senior. Jason McConville is 6'1 senior. And Lauren Howard, also who comes off the bench, is a 6'3 senior. Here are the starters for the Mustangs. They will start two seniors, two juniors, and a sophomore. Mark Stritt, 5'11 sophomore. He averages 8 a game. He scored 19 so far in the tournament. Lee Roman, a 6'4 senior. He averages 12 a game and 7 rebounds. He's their leading rebounder. He's got 18 in the tournament. Doug Leese is a 6-foot junior. On the regular season, 6.5 a game and 4.5 rebounds. He's chipped in 23 points. They've had very balanced scoring, whereas Sterling usually get most of their scoring from three of their players. Matt Stritt, a 6'3 senior, 11.5 a game, 6 rebounds, 21 points in the tournament. And Joe Reiners, a 6'4 junior, 9.5 game, 5.5 rebounds. He has 20 points in the tournament. So as you can see, they have very balanced scoring so far in the tournament. Non-starters for the Sterling Jets: Nathan Hausman, a 5'11 freshman. Luke Bold, a 5'10 senior. Kirk Hazen, 6'3 junior. Brad Wust, 5'10 junior. Jesse Bromeyer, a 6'1 senior. Justin Haynes, a 6'2 freshman. And Aaron Pella, a 5'10 senior. The Jets start three seniors and two juniors. Scott Hesterman is a 5'9 senior, 15 a game, 3 rebounds. Scott has 38 points in the tournament. Micah Yore is a 6'2 junior. He averaged 18.5 a game and 8 rebounds. He has 30 points for the tournament. Brent Hoisman is their wide body, 6'3 senior. He averages 4 a game and 4.5 rebounds. He has 9 points for the tournament. Jason Behrens is a 6'1 junior. 11.5 a game, 4 rebounds for the tournament so far, 28 points. And Alan Buss, who led them in scoring yesterday, or chipped in 20, I should say, yesterday, 6'4 senior, 12 points a game, 9.5 rebounds. He has poured in 30 points so far. So basically, Buss, Yore, and Hesterman do the scoring for the Jets, while the Mustangs, as we say, get very, very balanced scoring from their five starters and then get Andy Haig off the bench. So we'll see if Haig is a big factor today. He scored 17 yesterday coming off the bench in that win over Sargent. Here we go. Lee Vroman will go up against Alan Buss. The Class C2 title is on the line. Sterling looking for their third championship. Republican Valley their first. With the basketball, Republican Valley up top is Stritt. There's two Stritts, Mark and Matt. Down low they go, penetrating. There's a collision, and Joe Reiners collides with Hoisman. Hoisman was an All-State center in football, so Joe might want to pick on someone else. Charge against Reiners. Against the full court pressure, Scott Hesterman gets it across the line. Off it goes to Behrens. Now back to Hesterman. Scott pretty much runs the team and also is one of their leading scorers. Off it goes to Behrens. Back to Hesterman. Inside it goes to Alan Buss. There's Yore's shot. It's up and no good. Micah Yore puts up the shot, one and out. And the rebound goes to Leese. Doug Leese quickly in the front court to Stritt in the corner. Shot up by Vroman, no good. Alan Buss battles for the rebound and gets it. About a minute into the first quarter, no score. Hesterman's three-point shot, no good. Gets his own rebound, puts it back up from 12, in and out, no good. Alan Buss battles for the rebound and goes over the back. First foul for the Jets of Sterling goes against Alan Buss.
Fouls on Alan Buss.
We'll try and keep the Stritt brothers separated here. Mark Stritt, Matt Stritt. No score yet, 1 minute into the first quarter. Handling the basketball is Leese. Inside it goes, trying to wheel and deal is Matt Stritt. Out it comes to Mark. In the lane, shot up, left-handed shot up and good. That's Doug Leese with the first two of the game. Republican Valley takes the lead. Again, the backcourt pressure as Hesterman looks over the trap, guns it down court to Yore. Yore almost travels, bank shot up, good. Micah Yore.
Micah Yore.
Micah Yore. 6'2 junior, averages 18 and a half a game, ties it at two. On the other end, we've got Leese. They kick it back out to Mark Stritt. Off to brother Matt. Now they work it around the perimeter again. Against this, looks like 2-3 zone defense. That's Mark Stritt, tries to jam it inside, gets it inside, shot up and no good by Vroman. And we've got another foul on the rebound. Boy, they're really crashing the boards. Two very physical teams. That foul's going to be on the Mustangs.
Fouls on Matthew Stritt, his first personal foul. Second team foul against Republican.
Matt Stritt with his first foul. Second team foul. 2 minutes into the first quarter. This is not unusual for both of the teams here at the Sports Center to get off to a slow start. Hesterman gets it in the front court to Behrens. Behrens trying to work against Matthew Stritt. Off it goes to Yore. Inside, turnaround 15-footer by Alan Buss. Rolls around, in and out, no good. Boy, the lid seems to be on the basket early for the Jets. On the other end, driving, pulling up his Reiners. Almost traveled, tries to get a bounce pass out. Picked off by Behrens. Jason Behrens throws it away on the other end. Well, we'll get the nerves settled down here a little bit. That brings both coaches up to their feet. Dan Hilton for Republican Valley and Brad Buller for Sterling. 5:35 left to go first quarter. We're tied at two. Mark Stritt. Off it goes to Vroman. Down into the basket. A pass intended for Vroman. Picked off, and now we've got another foul in the backcourt. Hoisman came out of there with it. And already we've got three fouls. Three fouls against Republican Valley. Andy Haig, the 6'2 super soft, is in. He had 17 points yesterday. He averages 10 a game on the season and 6 rebounds. On the other end, Mikey Yore starts his drive and is cut off and fouled in there by Doug Leese. So rapidly, Republican Valley working their way into foul trouble.
Fourth team foul.
The only starter without a foul right now is Vroman. Micah Yore to inbounds. Lobs it into Alan Buss. We're tied at two. 5:18 left to go first quarter. Jason Behrens skip pass over the top to Hesterman. Hesterman drives, pulls up. Oh, has his shot blocked and it goes out of bounds. And Hesterman stands there and looks at the official. Scott Hesterman is only 5'9", but he is not afraid. We've seen him this year against Adams. He is not afraid to go inside, and he can maneuver very well. That time, he got rejected. Ewer lobs it into Behrens. Skip pass over the top. There's a three-point shot. Blocked in there, and then a foul on Hesterman. So that may get Scott thinking a little bit. He's had two of his shots blocked. That one was blocked by Doug Lease. First foul on Scott Hesterman.
Foul on Scott Hesterman, his first personal foul, second team foul against the Jets.
Still tied at two, almost 3 minutes into the first quarter. We've had some really great games in the boys' state tournament so far. Mark Stritt will bring it across the timeline. Off it goes to Lease, back to Stritt. And now Stritt travels. The sophomore, boy, both teams struggling right now. Sterling's being able to get the shots, except on that last series when they had two shots blocked. But they haven't been able to get them to go down. And right now the Mustangs having a little trouble handling the basketball. They throw up the 1-2-2 zone trap. Hesterman lobs it in the front court to Behrens. Off it goes to Micah Ewer. Ewer skip pass to Hesterman. Three-point shot. It is no good. So they may have intimidated him a little bit. That one was off by quite a ways. Still tied at two. As Lease brings it into the front court. Off it goes to Stritt. Stritt's three-pointer is good. Mark Stritt puts Republican Valley out in front 5-2. And now Behrens throws it away, and he threw it right to his coach, Brad Buller, and Brad is up and not happy at all. Right now, Republican Valley intimidating the Jets just a little bit. Number 21, Broman, returns to the Republican Valley lineup. Bold is in for Sterling. Down low, pass picked off by Jason Behrens. Long up court pass is almost stolen back, but knocked out of bounds by Scott Hesterman. And Brad Buller is up screaming at his players. 4:20 left to go, first quarter. Republican Valley out in front by 5-2. Looking for their first state championship ever. With the basketball is Mark Stritt. Matt off to brother Mark. Mark's shot is up. It's no good. Rebounded by brother Matt. Stolen away. Knocked loose on the court. And Luke Bolt picks it up. Luke Bolt. He and Hazen are the number one subs for Sterling. Now Hesterman looking. Off it goes to Bolt. Luke Bolt looking inside, kicks it out to Behrens. And Jason will set it back up for them. Off it goes to Micah Ewer. Ewer starts his drive, cut off at the baseline and fouled in there. Boy, he was so far under the basket, they should have let him shoot that one. But Doug Lease, I believe, picks up his second foul and will send Micah Ewer to the free throw line.
Second foul on Lease.
3:39 left to go in the first quarter, and now we've got a timeout. Timeout on the floor with 3:39 left to go in the first quarter. Republican Valley 5, Sterling 2. Well, both of these high-powered offenses have been held pretty much in check in the early going of the first quarter. Just 7 points scored in the first 4.5 minutes. Micah Ewer will inbounds right of his own basket. He has the only bucket for the Jets. Ewer kicks it way out front to Alan Buss, and he'll drop it off for Jason Behrens. Right wing to Scott Hesterman, who's not been a factor so far. Skip pass over the top for Ewer. Ewer pulls up, banks it off the glass. It won't go. Rebound battle for, and coming out of there with it, it's Roman, and he's fouled in there by Micah Ewer. Ewer missed. Fouled on the rebound.
His first personal foul, third team foul against Sterling. In for Republican Valley, number 42.
Number 42, Joe Reiner's back in for the Mustangs of Republican Valley. They'll play it in against backcourt pressure. Sterling, very good at this. But Republican Valley has no problem with it. With a basketball is Andy Haig. They get it out front to Mark Stritt. Stritt will set it up. Off it goes to Reiners. They kick it up to Vroman, working around the outer perimeter, looking inside against the zone. Nothing going. Handling it now is Mark Stritt. Off to Vroman. Shot out of the corner, up and no good by Matt Stritt. And as they battle for the rebound, ooh, I'll tell you, this could get very physical before this is all over. We've got a foul. This may be on Luke Bolt. It is. That's four team fouls on both teams now. And inbounds will be Matthew Stritt. Gets it into his brother. They just play catch. Mark Stritt handles it out front. Boy, this is a tough one, a sportscaster, when you got two brothers. And now the sophomore takes it straight to the hole, gets it down, and he's got Republican Valley out by five. Sterling, who averages 74 points a game, struggling underneath, wide open. Oh, nice pass from Bolt. Micah Ure has all 4 points for Sterling. Now Hesterman steals it back. Bounce pass under to Ure, and he's got another one. Four quick points, and we're tied at seven. That's what the press of Sterling can do to you. That's how they undressed Shelton yesterday. Mark Stritt off to brother Matthew. Matthew from 17, it won't go. Rebound to Alan Buss as he outdueled his own teammate Jason Behrens for the rebound. The Sterling fans on the other side. Three shot by Hesterman. Three-pointer by Hesterman, won't go. Rebound, Mark Stritt. Up court to Reiners. Reiners goes for the basket, and sneaking up on him and knocking it out of bounds is Scott Hesterman. Hesterman, quite an athlete. He's a long jumper and runs the hurdles in track. 4 year starter for Stern. Lauren Howard, number 55, is in, and Reiners is out. Matthew Stritt will inbounds. Right of his own basket, gets it into his brother. His brother puts up the 3-point shot, it won't go. Rebound, Behrens. Quickly out of there is Jason Behrens. Down court to Micah Ure. Oh, what a strip job by Mark Stritt. Micah Ure appeared to be going for a sure two and got stripped, and the ball goes out of bounds. So Ure will play it back in. Great defensive play by Mark Stritt. 3-point shot by Hesterman. It was just a matter of time. Scott Hesterman bangs down the three. So it's now a 9-7 ball game. On the other end, Republican Valley trying to tie it up or take the lead. There's a pass knocked out of bounds by Alan Buss, intended for Matthew Stritt down low, as Haig was trying to jam it down on the baseline. A minute 27 remaining, first quarter, 9-7 Sterling. Republican Valley inbounds, and now we've got a battle of bodies, and we're going to have a foul called on Lauren Howard, who set too strong a pick. Lauren Howard setting a good, tough pick on, I think it was Jason Behrens. A minute 25 left to go as the Sterling Jets will play it in. And now, Coach Dan Hilton wants his team to drop back out of the press. Hesterman handling way out front. Cross-court pass, that's Behrens. Wide open shot, in and out, no good. They crash the boards, and Luke Bolt will pick up his second foul. Luke Bolt, quite a football player in his own right, named the offensive player in the state last year, in his class, I believe. That's the fifth team foul against the Jets. Here come the Mustangs. Lauren Howard handles it on the left wing, kicks it up top now to Mark Stritt. Now they reverse it around to his brother Matthew. Back it comes to Mark. Inside it goes to Matthew Stritt, two-time, and fouled by Alan Buss. Uh-oh. The fouls start to mount. That's the second on Buss. Bolt has two. And on the other ledger, Doug Leese has two for the Mustangs. And he's out. And in to replace him will be Brent Hoisman. Hoisman, as we said, was an all-state center in football, so he's used to banging around underneath. Republican Valley plays it in, trailing by two. 48 seconds left to go, first quarter. Both teams have 16 fouls. There's Howard's shot. It's up and no good. Rebound battle for. Finally, Micah Ure comes up with it. Drops it off for Jason Behrens. Up court it comes to Hesterman. Now they'll pull it out and try and get one shot here, leading by two. Hesterman handling. Off it goes to Behrens, down to 23 seconds as they get it inside to Hoisman. Hoisman muscles his way to the basket, misses, but gets the loose ball, kept alive by Ure. 3-point shot, Scott Hesterman. So Scott got intimidated early, had a couple of shots blocked. On the other end, the shot is up, oh, way too strong by Lauren Howard. 5 seconds left to go. Ure's got to get up a shot. He does from 15 feet, no good. So Sterling, after getting off to a rocky start, and trailing 7-2, reels off 10 straight points at the end of the first quarter in the Class C2 state championship game. It's Sterling 12, Republican Valley 7.
Start the second quarter will be Sterling basketball.
Sterling will play it in to start the second quarter. The thing the Jets have to watch is their big center, Alan Busser, had 20 points yesterday. He's got two fouls. Inside it goes to Yor. Yor, wheels and deals, off the glass, it's good. I want to tell you, we've seen the Jets play this year, and Yor and Hesterman, both of their guards, neither one is afraid to go inside. Now, quickly on the other end, pulling up, the shot is up and good by Lee Vroman. Lee Vroman, who averages 12 a game, gets his first two. It's a 14-9 ball game. 7.5 minutes left to go. Inside, Buss's 15-footer rolls around and drops in. Oh, what a rainbow from Alan Buss as he gets his first two. 7-point lead for Sterling as both teams start to warm up offensively. Republican Valley breaks the press. Matthew Stritt gets it off to Reiners. Reiners' shot, no good, too strong. Ball goes out of bounds, and they say Sterling touched it last. Number 35, or number 55, Lauren Howard, is in, and out comes Reiners. Pass is inbounds, stolen away by Hesterman. Hesterman on the break, drops it off for Behrens, and it's an easy two. Behrens with his first two off of the steal and the assist from Hesterman. And now Republican Valley is falling apart as they throw it away. Doug Leese loses it out of bounds. Sterling's doubled the score at 18-9, and Coach Dan Hilton over talking to Joe Reiners, trying to get him calmed down. Now he may have to calm his whole team down. Hoistman's 12-footer, too strong off the glass. High to grab the rebound is Lauren Howard. Howard drops it off for Lisi. Off to Matthew Stritt. Handling the basketball now is number 32, Lease. In the corner comes Matthew Stritt. Jump shot won't go. Gets his own rebound at the free throw line. Kicks it back out to Leese. Leese. Matthew Stritt. Vroman. They just play catch outside. Haig is now in there against the zone. There's 6:18 left to go in the first half. Fake. Shot is up by Vroman. Counted. Lee Vroman bangs it down. Nice move. Head and shoulders fake. Got the Sterling defender off the floor. Went around him and canned it from 15. Republican Valley back within seven. We're 2 minutes into the second quarter. Behrens and Hesterman handling out front. In the corner it goes to Buss. Inside to Hoistman. Five-footer is up and good by Brent Hoistman. Now all five of the Sterling starters have scored. Just three starters have scored for Republican Valley. 20-11. As we say, Sterling's run away from both of the teams they played, while Republican Valley has had to, or been extended in all four quarters. They work it around the perimeter. Lauren Howard, nothing going, off to Haig. In the corner it goes. Matthew Stritt drives, left-handed bank shot won't go, but the putback is good by Lee Vroman. Vroman, who was silent in the first quarter, has six here in the second. He's got his team back within seven. Hesterman on the other end. Right wing it comes to Behrens. Behrens' three-point shot is no good. They crash the boards, and it's going to be over the back on number 30, Haig. Andy Haig will send Brent Hoistman to the line, where he is a 60%. Oh, wait a minute. They're going to send Micah Yor. Ooh, that's a 10-point percentage improvement at the free throw line. Micah Yor with 8 points. This is the first free throw attempt of the game. With 5:04 left to go in the first half, Yor's got it. Micah Yor.
In for the Mustangs, number 14, Mark Stritt.
2-year starter. Averaged 17 points per game last year. Mark Stritt is in, replacing his brother Matthew. Now Luke Bolt is in, and out comes Hoistman. Bolt comes in with two fouls. Brent Hoistman gets a blow. The big guy came in and did a good job. Got 2 points and a couple of rebounds. Micah Yor with his second free throw attempt, and it's good. Boy, what a rainbow that was. We've got timeout on the court. 5:04 left to go until intermission. Sterling has extended their lead to 9. It's the Jets 22, Republican Valley 13. Well, after leading 12-7 at the end of the first quarter, Sterling's outscored Republican Valley 10-6 here in the second quarter to extend their lead to 9. Lee Vroman will play it into the backcourt against full court pressure. His team is trailing by 9. We're 3 minutes into the second quarter. Gets it in to Mark Stritt. They just play catch in the backcourt. They're going to have to get going forward sooner or later. Stritt gets it in the front court to Haig. Down it goes to Howard. Howard cans it. Lauren Howard, the 6'3 senior, drills one. 7-point lead for Sterling. These are two high-scoring offenses trying to get on track. Sterling scores in the 70s. And Republican Valley in the mid-60s. Pass, tried to jam it down low. It's off the glass. Hesterman tried to jam it down low. It was deflected off the glass. And on the ricochet, Republican Valley gets it. They can get back within 5 or 4, depending on what they shoot here. Mark Stritt, bounce pass to Vroman. Cross-court pass to Lauren Howard. Inside, the shot is up by Haig. It won't go. High to grab the rebound is Luke Bolt. Outlet pass to Hesterman. And on the transition, here come the Jets. We're halfway through the second quarter. Jason Behrens looks inside, nothing going. Against the 2-1-2, they try and lob a pass to Micah Yor in the corner, and it's knocked out of bounds by Doug Leese. Michael will inbounds right of his own basket. He has been their leading scorer this year with 18.5 points a game. Out to Allen Buss, right wing to Hesterman. They work it around the perimeter. There's a three-point shot. No good by Yor. Rebound, Luke Bull. Put back is good. Luke Bull snuck inside, got the rebound of the putback. Again, the 9-point lead as Haig handles on the other end. That's off to Stritt. That's Mark Stritt. He's the only Stritt brother in there right now. He drives down the paint, puts the shot up. It's no good, but he's hooked on the way in by Hesterman. That's a second on Scott. So two of their three leading scorers, Allen Buss and Scott Hesterman, have 2 fouls apiece. Checking back in for the Mustangs will be Joe Reiners and Matthew Stritt. 3.5 minutes until intermission, and it's a 9-point lead for Sterling. But Mark Stritt will try and cut into that. He's a 65% free throw shooter. He's just a sophomore. Republican Valley starts 2 seniors, 2 juniors, and a sophomore. It's up and it's no good. Rebound, Allen Buss. Clears it out to Behrens, quickly in the front court to Hesterman. Behrens up top, looking inside, back to Hesterman. Inside to Bolt. They work it around. Inside Buss, turnaround, 12-footer. It is no good. Rolls across the ring. Luke Bolt is there again. His return shot, no good. Allen Buss gets the rebound and is fouled from behind. So the Jets missed 3 shots, but got the foul. Second foul on Joe Reiners as Allen Buss heads to the free throw line. Buss is in the Army Reserves, is an honor roll student, and was the All-State Defensive Player of the Year in C2 last year. Allen Buss, that's quite an accomplishment. However, he throws up a brick here for a free throw. Just kidding, Allen. 3:11 left to go in the first half as Brent Hoisman gets set to check back in for the Sterling Jets. Here's the second free throw by Buss, and it gets there. So Allen got it measured on the second attempt. He's got 3 points. Buss is out, and Hoisman is in. 3:11 left to go as Sterling has built their 5-point first quarter lead to 10. They double up on the basketball. Luke Bolt picks it off. Down court to Behrens. Behrens has it stolen back by Leese, but then he starts to fly out of bounds, flips it in, Bolt gets it, down low to Hoisman, and Hoisman travels trying to muscle his way to the basket. What a chain of events that was. The ball and bodies flying all over the place. 2:50 and counting down as Mark Stritt gets it across the timeline to Leese. Leese cut off, two time, inside to Reiners, Out it comes. Mark Stritz wide open. Three-point shot is short. Hesterman rebound. They've got a breakaway. Here comes Behrens. Behrens on the breakaway scores. Behrens on the breakaway. As Republican Valley didn't get back on defense, they trail by 12. They jumped off to a 7-2 lead. Pass inside and getting it down is Roman. So Lee Vroman's been the only bright spot for the Mustangs here in the second quarter. He's got 8. But it was 7-2 at one time. So 25-15 has been the margin. Shot by Behrens, no good. They crash the boards. Who's the foul on? Someone over the back. Yours clapping his hands. Looks like it's going to be on Doug Leese. If it is, it's his third.
Foul's on Doug Leese, his third person.
So Republican Valley's been outscored 25-10 since they led 7-2. Lauren Howard checks in as Leese hits the Pines. Micah Yore is 2-for-2 from the charity stripe, has 10 points. This one's going to be short. Rebound and the putback by Hoisman, no good. And the rebound inside, and a foul. Republican Valley's letting Sterling get inside. And Coach Dan Hilton is not happy about that. He wants timeout. Republican Valley's not only down by 10, but they're getting pounded on the offensive boards, or on their defensive boards. So Coach Dan Hilton wants to talk about it. 1:59 left to go until intermission. Sterling 27, Republican Valley 17. The line will be Jason Behrens as play resumes. He's a 70% free throw shooter. His first opportunity from the line. It's up and good. Jason was 5 points now, all in the second quarter. Now Haig and Spencer Neely into the Republican Valley lineup. I think Coach Dan Hilton for the Mustangs would be very happy right now to get it down into single digits before halftime. His team got up to a 7-2 lead, and since then it's been all Sterling. Behrens with the rebound, or with the second free throw, I should say. Gives Sterling a 12-point lead. Haig in the backcourt. They better hurry. They get it across the timeline to Mark Stritt. His pass deflected by Hoisman. Picked off by Micah Yore. So the quick hands of Brent Hoisman. Down the lane comes Yore. Oh, wheeling and dealing down the lane, Micah Yore. 12 points for Yore. Haig is fouled in the backcourt by Bolt. Luke Bolt picks up his third foul. And now Kirk Hazen will be in to replace him with a minute 36 left to go. Kirk Hazen, a 6'3 junior, averages 3.5 a game. He's in and Bolt is out. Nice hand for Luke Bolt, who did a great job off the bench. He gave them the spark they needed when they were flatter than a pancake. Free throw by Haig is up and good. So the Super Soft has his first point of the day. It's a 13-point lead for Sterling. Sterling threatened to run away and hide. Second free throw, no good. And then two Sterling players have a hand on it but can't control it and lose it out of bounds. So Republican Valley gets a break. Matthew Stritt gets it into Neely. Back to Stritt. Matthew out to brother Mark. A minute 28 left to go. They could really use a three here. Get them back within 10. Off it goes to Neely. Neely kicks it out to Vroman. Inside it goes. Turnaround jump shot up and good by Matthew Stritt. Matthew Stritt with his first two. It's an 11-point lead for Sterling as Hesterman weaves his way through traffic, gets it up to Mikey Orr. Tries to jam it inside. It's stolen away briefly by Neely, but he can't control it and lose it out of bounds. Oh, wait a minute. Whoa, you got to be kidding. I'm not trying to ref this one, but there, that was touched last by Republican Valley. There's no two ways about it. Republican Valley with the basketball. Going for the steal is Behrens. Doesn't quite get it. Gets a hand on it. Mark Stritt on the other end. Gets it off to Vroman. Back to Stritt. Vroman in the corner. Hazen's in his face. Down to 42 seconds until intermission. Off it goes to Matthew Stritt. Back to Mark Stritt. Inside. That's Vroman. Down to a half minute. There's a shot up by Vroman. It is no good. Rebound, Micah Yor. Outlet pass to Behrens. Behrens pulls up on the other end. And now Scott Hesterman says one shot as it's down to 18 seconds. The Jets should lead by at least 11, possibly more if they can hit the final shot. Down to 10 seconds. Three-point shot by Hesterman. It's no good. They crash the boards. Let's see if Republican Valley can get a shot off. There's a 60-footer out of bounds. That's the end of the first half at halftime. The second innings 20.
Republican Valley basketball.
What a turnaround of the first half. We're at halftime. Sterling leads 31-20. Republican Valley jumped off to a 7-2 lead. And since then, they've been outscored 29-13. They, in fact, intimidated Sterling early, blocking a couple of Scott Hesterman's shots. But since then, they have really cranked up and gotten that balance scoring, which they usually don't get. But the unofficial scoring at halftime, leading all scorers, Micah Yor of Sterling with 12, 6 for Hesterman and for Behrens, 3 for Buss, and 2 each for Hoisman and Bolt. Leading the Mustang scoring of Republican Valley is Vroman with 8, all 8 coming in the second quarter, 5 for Mark Stritt, 2 each for Lauren Howard, Matthew Stritt and Doug Leese, and 1 point for Andy Haig. So here we go, the second half of the Class C2 championship. Will Sterling win their third state championship, or will Republican Valley claim their first? We'll know in 16 minutes of actual playing time. To inbounds will be Matthew Stritt. The fans starting to get into it here. Here we go. The Stritt brothers play it in. Mark off to Matthew. Down low it goes to Reiners. Reiners tries to jam a pass down low to Leese, and already we've got the first foul of the second half. It's going to be on Jason Behrens. Behrens a little slow getting back to cover on the weak side. And that's the first on Jason. Leese has 3. They only started with 3 fouls, but there's some that could get in trouble in a hurry. 3-point shot up and no good. Missed by Matthew Stritt. One and out. On the other end for Sterling. Behrens, 10-footer is an air ball, but running it down is Hoisman. Hoisman puts up an air ball. So 2 air balls in a row from Sterling, as the shot selection might not have been quite what Brad Buller wanted. On the other end, Republican Valley trying to get back into this early in the second half. With the basketball is Vroman, who led their scoring in the first half. Off to Mark Stritt. Leese looking. Now has to kick it out to Vroman. They'll try and be patient. Sometimes that's easier said than done. Right down the lane. Oh, beautiful pass from Reiners, who hit a streaking Mark Stritt right down the lane, and he caught Sterling flat-footed. The shot was up before the Jets could react. Republican Valley back within 9. We've played a minute of the third quarter. They play catch out front. Both teams have basically played zone. Of course, you've got to remember, this is the third game in as many days, and these kids, I don't care how young you are, still got to be a little tired. There's a shot up by Micah Yor. It bounces around, won't go. Oh, we've got a clear out foul. Hoisman hit the deck. Someone got him from behind as the ball went high in the air. They tried to time the rebound, but it went high in the air. But Doug Leese picks up his 4th foul. That's not good news for the Mustangs. Sterling plays it into Hesterman. Hesterman goes for the basket. Misses. Rebound Allen Buss. And Allen is elbowed in the face. And we've got another foul. So just as happened in the first quarter, Republican Valley picks up a bunch of fouls right off the bat. That's the 3rd foul on Reiners. So 2 of the 3 starters are in big foul trouble. And Coach Dan Hilton wants timeout. He realizes he doesn't want this game to get away from him early in the second half, as explosive as Sterling is. Timeout, Republican Valley. 6:36 left to go in the third quarter. It's Sterling 31, Republican Valley 22. Well, three quick fouls against Republican Valley has got two of their players in deep foul trouble a minute and a half into the third quarter. As play resumes, Sterling's Micah Uhr will play it in. Flips it out to Hesterman. Oh, they almost threw it out of bounds. And now it appears that Republican Valley is going to go man-to-man. Out it comes to Micah Uhr. Right down the lane. Collision. Blocking foul. A basket won't count. The blocking foul against Joe Reiners. That's his fourth. Oh, Coach Dan Hilton is saying, wait a minute, guys. Two quick substitutions. Andy Haig and Lauren Howard come in. And the two guys with four fouls hit the bench. Again, Micah Uhr gets it in, this time to Jason Behrens. Back out to Allen Buss. Uhr behind the pick, gets the shot up, and it's good. Two-pointer for Micah Uhr. Uhr continues to lead all scorers. He's got 14. Republican Valley on the other end, still trailing by 11 as they did at halftime. We've played 2 minutes of the third quarter in the C2 state championship game for 1993. Republican Valley's had to fight, scratch, claw their way into the championships. It's come a little bit easier for Sterling. Inside, Matthew Stritt, turnaround, jump shot, good. Matthew Stritt now with 4 points has got the Mustangs back within eight. Well, that can't be right. We'll have to wait and see here. Driving shot up by Micah Uhr. No good. Rebound is Hoistman, and we've got a foul, and I believe it's going to be on Lauren Howard. Republican Valley's going to have to do a better job of blocking out. On the defensive boards, they're allowing Sterling to get inside. That's the second foul on Howard. They did correct the score. It has now 9 points. 33-24. Sterling by nine. Hesterman penetrates, goes in, hanging 10-footer, rolls around and drops in. Boy, we've seen this kid at 5'9 go inside effectively so many times. Now there's a steal by Behrens. Behrens steals, scores. Quickly, it's up to 13 points. This is what happened. This is what gave Sterling the lead in the first half, is the steals. They get it in the front court to Howard. Off it goes to Broman. He tries to jam it back inside to Howard, and the quick hands of Sterling knock it away. And it's picked up loose in there, and here comes Jason Behrens. 4:50 left to go, third quarter. Now there's the steal back. On the breakaway, here comes Andy Haig on the breakaway, and he's got it. Andy Haig returns the favor. 37-26, Sterling by 11. That's what they led by at halftime. 4.5 minutes left to go. Hesterman pulls up. His soft shot rolls around and drops in. Hesterman, with that soft running jump shot, got it to bounce around and drop. In the front court, they get it to Matthew Stritt. And he tries to get it inside. It's kicked out of bounds by Sterling.
In for Republican Valley,
number 32. Doug Lease checks in with four fouls, and out goes Mark Stritt. Here comes Luke Bolt for Sterling. 4:14 left to go in this third quarter. Sterling by 13. Matthew Stritt gets it into Haig. Back to Stritt. Runs the baseline and travels. Stritt had the right idea. He wanted to run the baseline, then shovel it inside the Lease. He did, but he traveled before he got the pass off. Turnover, Republican Valley. We're halfway through the third quarter. Slowly up court across the timeline comes Behrens. Off to Uhr. Uhr drives, comes out from behind the glass, and is clobbered. Bodies here, bodies there, bodies everywhere. Micah Uhr is so quick. He and Hesterman give a coach the ultimate weapon, someone who can shoot the three. You fake that, go inside, and they can wheel and deal inside. Third foul on Matthew Stritt. Two shots for Micah Uhr. Yours free throw is no good. Yore with 14 points is a 70% free throw shooter. Exactly 4 minutes left to go, third quarter. Second free throw is good. Sterling has outscored the Mustangs 9-6 in the early going of the fourth or third quarter. Up court it comes to Roman. Roman to Haig, back to Roman. The Jets of Sterling continue to dance around that 1-3-1 off our defense. And now there's a drive by Lease and a foul on Allen Buss. Allen Buss picks up his third foul. He joins Luke Bolt with three. And now let's see what decision Brad Bowler decides to make. Number 31, Spencer Neely, checks in for the Mustangs. And out goes Lauren Howard. 3:40 left to go as Doug Lease heads for the free throw line. His first trip to the stripe. And he misses. He's a 60% free throw shooter. Republican Valley trying to close the gap, the 14-point gap right now, before they head into the fourth quarter. Both shots missed. Rebound slapped away and picked up by Mikey Yore. Drops it off for Scott Hesterman. Hesterman across the timeline. Comes to Yore. Yore from 17 feet. It's going to be off the mark. They crash the boards and Allen Buss over the back, and Allen's got four. Allen Buss would have been better off to let that one go. Anytime you're that far behind the defensive player. So Buss is out and Hoistman back in. Height advantage right now, Republican Valley. 3:28 left to go in the third quarter. Sterling by 14. Republican Valley just needs to steady their ship here and start to hit a few against the full court pressure. Vroman off it goes to Lease. Lease tries to split two defenders. Now tries to get it down low, and there's a foul on Luke Bolt, his fourth. And Brad Buller is up and really angry. I'm not sure whether he's angry at his players or at the officials. Fourth foul on Bolt. I think what Brad is mad about is these kids have to know what their foul situation is and react accordingly. If it's going to be a close play where they could pick up a foul, they've got to back off. Bolt is out and Kirk Hazen checks in. Republican Valley plays it in. With the basketball is Neely. Inside it goes to Haig. Haig short bank shot is good. The sophomore gets inside and scores. He's got 5 points. And Republican Valley's back within 12. 3 minutes left to go, third quarter. Jason Behrens calls timeout as he gets trapped in the backcourt. Sterling wants timeout to talk things over. Just when it appeared they were going to run away and hide with this game, Republican Valley starts to work their way back in. Timeout on the court. 2:54 remaining, third quarter. Sterling 40, Republican Valley 28. Well, it'll be interesting to see what strategy Brad Buller of Sterling employs here. His team is up by 12, but they've been struggling. Their tallest player's in foul trouble. And Hoistman gets it in to Kirk Hazen. Hazen will drop it off for Hesterman. Hesterman against the man-to-man gets picked up by Mark Stritt. Off it goes to Behrens. So Republican Valley's come out of their zone to go man-to-man. Off to Hoistman. Hoistman drives, 12-footer off the glass, way too strong. Way too strong. Republican Valley with the rebound and a chance to get back within 10. They trail by 11 at halftime. Haig, off it goes to Neely. They reverse it around to the other side. Driving, the shot is up and no good by Vroman, and he's fouled on the way in. So the momentum seems to be switching to Republican Valley. Let's see if they can take advantage of it. The foul, I believe, is going to be on Hazen. It will send Vroman to the free throw line where he's a 70% free throw shooter.
Kirk Hazen, his first personal foul, 15th foul against Sterling. At the line for Republican Valley, number 21, Lee Vroman, shooting two.
Vroman, as we say, a 70% free throw shooter, has got this one. All 8 of his points came in the second quarter. He's now got 9 with that free throw. He can bring his team back within 10. It's up and good. Neither one hit pure net, but he got them both down. Full court pressure. Hesterman flies across the timeline. Goes right wing, where he's picked up by Mark Stripp. Almost fouled, but not quite. Off it goes to Behrens. Republican Valley knows that their defense probably is going to have to get them back in this game, and they've gone to a very tenacious man-to-man. Behrens handles off to Hesterman. Pulls up at the free throw line. 16-footer, no good. Rebound, Roman. High to grab the board, leave Roman. Long down court pass to Neely. Neely pulls up, short bank shot, won't go. Rebound loose, Kirk Hazen comes up with it. Neely almost got the rebound. Hesterman on the other end. He pulls up, goes up for the shot and is hammered. Foul's going to be on Neely. As we say, Hesterman at 5'9", it loves to go inside. I won't not only say he's not afraid to, he loves to go inside. It was his three-point shot with 10 seconds left to go that knocked off Adams to give Adams their only defeat of the year. Hesterman at the line as Neely picked up his first foul. Scott's a 75% free throw shooter, and it's down. A minute 43 left to go in the third quarter, and Sterling leads by the same margin they did at halftime, 11. Hesterman, it's up and good. 6 points in this third quarter for Hesterman. He's got 12 on the game. Haig across the timeline. Kicks it off to Vroman. Vroman, 13-footer. Rebound. Hoistman. Outlet pass. Rolls to Behrens. Here come the Jets with a minute 25 left to go. Third quarter up by 12. Hesterman penetrates in the lane. Drops it off for Hoistman. Hoistman goes up and he's fouled by Haig. Great penetration by Hesterman. So they're not pulling it out. They're still going full steam ahead. Hoistman is a 60% free throw shooter. He's missed his only other attempt. With a minute 20 remaining third quarter, Sterling's got a 12-point lead. Make it 13. Hoistman gets his first point of the third period. Sterling trying to put even more distance between them and Republican Valley. Second free throw, it's good. The Sterling Jets were ranked number one in C2 for quite a while. Now, stolen away by Hoistman. Hoistman steals it away, gets it to Mikey Yore. They're hollering over and back, and they do get the coaching staff. No, wait a minute, timeout. Timeout, Sterling. Coach Dan Hilton was screaming over and back as Mikey Yore was going back and forth at the timeline, and I'm not sure he didn't have a legitimate call there. But in the meantime, Sterling quickly calls timeout. And no turnover. So timeout Sterling. 108 left to go, third quarter. The Jets 44, Republican Valley 30. As play resumes, Sterling will inbounds right in front of the scorer's table, leading by 14. Let's see if Brad Buller, their head coach, wants him to just sort of hang on to the basketball here and run out the clock. Boy, that's hard for people like Hesterman and Yore to do. Hesterman picked up by Mark Stritt as he crosses the timeline. Off to Yore. Kicks it out to Behrens. Oh, almost picked off. Behrens, 17-footer, is going to be short off the side of the ring and out of bounds. Behrens just barely got a piece of the ring. 53.7 seconds remain. As Republican Valley inbounds, they're down by 14. A three here would get them back to the 11-point margin they trailed by at halftime. With the basketball is Roman. Mark Stritt off to brother Matthew. He penetrates. His 8-footer rolls across the ring. Rebound Roman. He's fouled. Both teams have a little trouble boxing off underneath. And I believe that's going to be on Hazen.
Well, Hazen, yep. Second foul
on Hazen. Republican Valley inbounds. With the basketball is Stritt. Off it goes. Bingo, three-point shot by Matthew Stritt. He got the pass. The assist will go to his brother, and Matthew Stritt knocks it down. So they're back within 11 with 20 seconds left to go. Hesterman looking, lobs it to Yore. Yore drives, pulls up. His shot too long. Rebound Behrens. Behrens muscles his way in. He misses. Rebound Republican Valley. They've got 6 seconds. Up court it comes. and the ball is lost by Haig. There's a desperation shot by Hoisman. So Sterling does a great job of not allowing Republican Valley the last shot of the third quarter. We've played three quarters, and the margin is the same as at halftime. After three, it's Sterling 44, Republican Valley 33.
By the American flag.
Here we go with the final 8 minutes of the C2 state championship game. Will Republican Valley claim their first state championship, or will Sterling pick up their third? Luke Bolt and Alan Buss, both with four fouls, are in the lineup to start the fourth quarter. Hesterman flies across the timeline, is picked up there by Haig. Hesterman tries to penetrate, nothing going, kicks it off for Behrens. Behrens brings it back out front as Republican Valley's gone man-to-man. Buss drops it off for Bolt. Back out to Buss. Against the man-to-man, they work the ball, right wing to Buss. Down low it goes to Ure. Ure, turnaround 10-footer is no good, and he 3 seconds. They got it down to Micah. Great job by Vroman of staying right with him. He didn't take any of the head and shoulders fakes and gets the turnover. That caused by Lee Vroman. Republican Valley trying to cut this down into single digits here. They get it across the timeline to Lee Vroman. Vroman's their leading scorer with 10 points. Off it goes to Lease, who's been in foul trouble. Down low it goes to Vroman. Under the basket, reverse layup. No good by Matthew Stripp. The put up by Reiners, no good. He gets it back, puts it up. Oh, rolls across the ring. They get three cracks at it. Reiners got two of them. Neither one went down, but they got the foul.
Fouls on Jason Behrens, his second personal foul.
Jason Behrens, who can afford a few fouls, gets them.
At the free throw line for Republican Valley, number 4.
Joe Reiners, a 65% free throw shooter, is at the line. We're a minute into the fourth quarter. Free throw is good. That's the first point of the morning for Joe Reiners, who averaged almost 10 points a game in the regular season. Second one, no good. Micah Ure with the rebound. Off it goes to Hesterman. 10-point lead for Sterling. Hesterman pulls up from 13, rolls across the ring, no good. Oh, great rebound, Reiners. Joe Reiners making his presence known. Kicks it up court to Lease. Off it goes to Matthews. Stripp, no good. Oh, yes! Bounces straight up in the air and drops through.
Stripp
now with 9 points. And the Republican Valley Mustangs are making a run, and their fans get into it. We're a minute and a half into the fourth quarter, and their fans are getting cranked up down below us here. Bounce pass off to Hesterman. A basket here would silence them. Off it goes to Luke Bull. Hesterman, his shot is up and good. 2-point shot by Hesterman. Hesterman with 14 points, and that gets the Sterling fans cranked up on the other end. Down court, a pass from Lease to Reiners. And Reiners is fouled again. So Joe Reiners will head right back to the free throw line. Luke Bolt is gone. Luke Bolt fouls out, but he contributed quite a bit to the comeback, especially in the second quarter. And he'll be replaced by Brent Hoisman. A 10-point lead for the Sterling Jets. One of their players is fouled out. Alan Buss is playing with four. Reiners' free throw is up and good. So he's 2 out of 3 from the stripe. Reiners and Doug Lease each have 4 fouls for the Mustangs. So he can cut it down to 8. Here it comes, and it's going to be way short. But the rebound goes to Vroman. Vroman to Matthew Stripp. Inside, shot by Haig is up and no good. They battle for the rebound. The putback is good by Reiners. Joe Reiners is really, really gone bonkers on the boards. 7-point lead. Sterling has it, and they have the basketball. Ure from the free throw line. His shot's going to come up short. That's what happens when you're a little tired. Sterling not running any time off the clock or very little. Haig on the other end. Cross-court pass. Out of the corner. There's Matthew Stritt. It won't go. Rebound Ure. Haig had a notion to go over the back. Great positioning by Micah Ure. Now Hesterman will bring it in the front court. 5:25 left to go in the game, and the game is really heating up. 14-foot shot, Hesterman. Brad Bohr, whenever he wants a key bucket, many times will go to Hesterman. Across the timeline. Now Matthew Strent kicks it away. On the other end, three-point shot by Hesterman. It's going to be way strong. Uehr with a rebound. Micah Uehr, put back good.
Micah Uehr.
Uehr now with 17 points. As Sterling answers with two buckets of their own, and their lead is back up to 11, which has been a very popular lead for them here in the second half. Driving is Roman, cut off by Uehr. They kick it back out front. Lease drives, pulls up, off the glass, good. Doug Lease with his first points of the second half. 50-41, still a lot of time left, 4.5 minutes, and a 9-point lead for Sterling. Here comes Jason Behrens. Behrens, off it goes to Hesterman. Hesterman works down to the right side, pulls up, off the glass. Oh, my gosh, this kid is uncanny. 18 points for Hesterman on a falling away bank shot. Again, the lead is 11. Across the timeline come the Mustangs. Driving is Roman. Roman answers on the other end.
Leave
Roman with his first basket of the second half. He led their scoring with 8 at halftime. The lead is down to 9. 3:55 left to go in the contest. Sterling by 9. Allen Buss off to Hesterman. Here's his 13-footer. Good. Oh, man.
Scott
Hesterman is on fire. 4 straight baskets. 11-point lead, and now Hoisman picks off the pass. 3-on-1 break, and there's the foul, and Lease is gone. Doug Lease is gone as he laid a pretty good foul on Micah Uehr.
Fouls on Doug Lease, his fifth personal foul.
Doug Lease fouls out. And we'll be replaying. Now there's two replacements.
Neely
is in. And Mark Stritt is in. So Micah Uehr will go to the stripe. Now Republican Valley wants timeout. 3:36 remaining in the game. Sterling by 11, 54-43. Well, to show you what kind of an impact player Scott Hesterman is, at halftime, Micah Uehr had 12 points. Hesterman had just 6. Now with 3:36 left to go in the game, Hesterman has 18, and Micah Uehr has 17. At the line will be Uehr. As play resumes, Uehr's been their leading scorer all year. And he gets that one to roll around and drop in. So Uehr and Hesterman tied with 18 points apiece. Second shot is good. Oh, Hesterman almost steals the inbounds pass. Sterling by 13, and the students and fans across the way are sensing their third state championship is just 3 minutes and 35 seconds away. Vroman gets it in finally to Matthew Stritt. Against the full court pressure, Sterling's going to make him earn it. Boy, they're going to have to hurry. Haig lobs it way down to Mark Stritt. Stritt penetrates. 15-footer is on air ball. Uehr grabs it, drops it off for Hesterman. Brad Buller is up shouting out instructions. Hesterman. Off it goes to Behrens. I would imagine he'd like him to run a little bit of time off, but they have a tough time slowing things up. They're such a full steam ahead team. Hesterman. Yeah, they're just going to play catch out front. Down to 3 minutes. They know that if they can handle the basketball, there's no way Republican Valley can make up 13 points in 2 minutes and 54 seconds. There's a foul going to be whistled on Matthew Stritt, his fourth. So it may take us a while to play this final 2:54. And Behrens will go to the free throw line, where he's 2 for 2. 8 points for the steady Jason Behrens. Jason is a 70% free throw shooter. Here comes his shot, and it's short, no good. So we may see more of this, especially if the Jets can't make their free throws. 2:45. As Mark Stritt brings it across the timeline and throws it away. Oh, ouch. Ouch, ouch, ouch. when you're trailing by 13, Dan Wolf comes in, and out goes Mark Stritt. Sterling will play it in as Buss gets it into Behrens. Down course it comes to Hoistman. Hoistman drives off the glass, too strong. Rebound, Republican Valley. Off it goes to Wolf. 2:35 left. In the corner it goes to Matthew Stritt. He penetrates in the lane and banks it off the glass. Matthew Stritt now with 11 points. 2:20 left to go. Hesterman will handle in the backcourt. Sterling by 11. Hesterman across the timeline, still going. And now a blocking foul is going to be called on Neely. Spencer Neely with his second foul. Hesterman, who's 2-for-2 from the free throw line and a 75% free throw shooter, heads to the stripe.
At the free throw line, shooting 1-1 for the Jets.
20 points for Hesterman. Scott's free throw is good. Just crawled over the front of the rim. So Scott Hesterman continues to singe the nets here in the second half. Here comes his second attempt, and it's good. 22 points for Hesterman. Now we've got timeout on the court. 2:16. That's all that's between the Sterling Jets and their third state championship. It's Sterling 58, Republican Valley 45. Well, a lot of players are close to fouling out of this game. One already has in Luke Bolt of Sterling. As play resumes, Republican Valley will play it in the backcourt. They've got a monumental task of trying to make up 13 points in 2 minutes and 15 seconds. Long down court pass to Roman. Off to Haig. Haig's three-pointer. Good! Andy Haig's got him back within 10. Sterling plays it in. Yore bumped in the backcourt and fouled by Haig. He's one of the few players that can give some up. So with a minute 59, it's not impossible in the day of the three-point play, but what you have to have is the other team constantly miss their free throws and go down and answer on the other end. Here's Micah Yore. Yore is 5 out of 6 from the free throw line. His free throw is up and good. So he's not quite the guy to foul. He and Hesterman and Behrens, their three best free throw shooters in the starting lineup. Second attempt, rolls around and drops in. 19 points for Yore. On the other end, the three-point shot is up and no good by Wolf. Rebound, Haig. Put back, no good. Allen Buss rebounds. Outlet pass to Behrens. It's knocked loose. Behrens runs it down. Behrens pulls up. A minute 40 between Sterling and the state championship. Hesterman is fouled out near the line by Wolf. Brad Buller is up and encouraging his kids. He realizes what's about to happen to him for the first time. And that's he's about to claim a state championship. Hesterman will be at the line when play resumes. Timeout, 1:38 left to go. And it's Sterling 60, Republican Valley 48. A minute 38 is all that's between Sterling and a jubilant celebration. Scott Hesterman, who's 4 out of 4 from the free throw line. He's got 22 points. Make it 23. This kid is a 4-year starter, all-conference last year, honor roll student, second team All-State last year, and he qualified in the state in the long jump and the hurdles, and he's 5'9". Second free throw is good. And I'm sure he'll be on the all-tournament team here. A minute 35 left to go. Off it goes to Wolf. Down inside, a pass picked off by Allen Buss. Buss is fouled in the backcourt by Reiners, and Reiners is gone. So now Coach Dan Hilton sees this game's over with, and he's going to start to send in some subs, as I'm sure Brad Buller will. Just a minute and a half left to go, and Sterling by 14. Number 20, Jason Long.
Number 24,
24 is Kurt Kiker. And 44, Jason McConville is in. Alan Buss. Allen's one out of two from the free throw line. His free throw is good. That's the first point of the second half for Allen. But he's been in foul trouble most of the second half. So the lead is 15. Going for 16, and it's there. 64-48. Across the timeline comes Wolf. There's a pass picked off, picked off by Urey. Tries to save it, throws it away, but running it down is Behrens, and a pushing foul is going to be called as number 20, Jason Long, pushed Behrens right out of bounds. Jason Behrens will go to the free throw line, or Jason Long, I should say. And the other Jason, Behrens, will go to the free throw line. Behrens is two out of three from the stripe. Here's his free throw attempt, and it's short, no good. Rebound held on to, and on the held possession, it will go to Republican Valley. A minute 19 left to go. Coach Brad Buller looking like an expectant father over there, pacing the sidelines. He'll be sending in the rest of his troops here in a moment as Micah Yore knocks it out of bounds with a minute 13 left to go. He's still not sure. He's still not convinced that 16 points is going to hold up in the final minute and 13. He surely will get the rest of his kids in here. Republican Valley with the basketball. Wolf gets it off to Hague. Hague penetrates and tries to drop off a pass. It's loose on the court. And on the held ball, it'll go over to Sterling. It'll go over to Sterling. And now they want timeout. They want timeout so they can get their substitutions in. Timeout Sterling, 101 left in the game. Sterling 64, Republican Valley 48. Well, I was wrong. All the starters are still in there. So the Jets will play it in. There's a long lead pass to Hesterman. Hesterman on the breakaway and an easy 2 points for Hesterman. Hesterman scores with a minute left to go, and now Coach Brad Buller is going to send in the troops. There's a pass almost picked off. With it is Long. Long, and now there's a foul in the backcourt on Hoisman. Hoisman going for the steal doesn't get it, but it will allow all the subs to get in for Sterling. And now here come the non-starters. Hazen comes in. Brad Wuss, 34, Jesse Brohmeyer, Justin Haynes, number 40, and number 44, Aaron Pella. At the free throw line will be Kurt Kiker. Kiker sends up the free throw, and it's way strong. Rebound and put back is no good by Hague. They battle for the rebound. Coming up with it is Wuss, and as Brad starts down, Cordy's fouled by Wolf with 38 seconds left to go. So Sterling just waiting to erupt across the way. Nathan Hoisman checks in. And so now all the Sterling players have gotten in. Wuss comes in. Well, let's see if Brad, a 5'10 junior, can get on the scoreboard here. It's no good. Rebound to Republican Valley with 35 seconds left to go. Sterling getting set to erupt across the way. Penetrating as Pella, and he's fouled on the way in. And you wonder why. This game was already decided, but the non-starters want to have a shot at things. Brad Wusk gets the foul, and at the line will be Wolf. And probably if he misses, we'll have another foul and go down to the other end. Wolf's free throw is short, no good. Rebound coming up with it is Justin Haynes. Haynes throws it down court and throws it out of bounds with 26 seconds left to go. 66-48. Sterling will win this one going away. There's a three-point shot up and no good by number 20, Long. Rebound is by number 40, Justin Haynes. Up court pass picked off, 13 seconds left to go. Wolf gets off the pass. The shot is up, and it is in and out and back in by Jason McConville. McConville, 3 seconds, and now we've got a foul in the backcourt with 2 seconds left to go. And again, you say, why? This game is all over, Dan Wolf. And headed to the line will be number 10, Nathan Hoisman, just a 5'11 freshman. Nathan's free throw is short, no good. They battle for the rebound, and that's going to do it. Final score as Sterling wins their third state championship. The final from the Bob Devaney Sports Center, Sterling 66, Republican Valley 50.
The 1990